Welcome to our few moments together on the Parsha. This Shabbos, Shabbos Chanukah, we have the privilege of reading Parshas Miketz. We know that Yosef is taken out of the pit. He interprets the dreams for Paro. He's appointed the viceroy over the land of Egypt. And the Torah tells us that he marries Osnas, the daughter of Potipharah, and she has two children with him. He calls the older one Menashe, as the Pasuk says, Ki Nashani Elokim, because Hashem has helped me to become a creditor for all the goodness that has happened to me, as Rav Shamshon Falahirsch explains, that all my toil, all my father's house has helped me to reach this day. If you have an opportunity, look at Rav Hirsch's interpretation on the word Menashe, as we so beautifully translated it, not to mean forgetting, but as a creditor. The second son he calls Ephraim. And the Torah says, why does he call him Ephraim? Ki Hifrani Elokim, because Hashem has made me fruitful. From the word pri, Ki Hifrani Elokim, because Hashem has made me fruitful, Be'eretz Onyi, in the land of my affliction. How poignant. Yosef has this child Ephraim. And Ephraim, you know, Ephraim is the name of the 10 lost tribes. Habein Yakir li Ephraim, says Yirmiyahu in Perek Lamed Aleph. Habein Yakir li Ephraim, is not my son Ephraim the most beloved? Ki midei dabri bo, and because every time I speak to him, Zohor es Kerenu od, I keep remembering him. Al kein homu meilo, therefore my innards just crazily desire him and long for him. Rachem arachmenu ne'um Hashem. And ultimately, I will have great mercy on him and the Jewish people will come back home, Ephraim being the lost Jewish people who Hashem so desires. And the Jewish people are so desired by Hashem. When Yosef calls his second son Ephraim, he's at the top of the world. He is second only to Paro. He's achieved greatness. But within that greatness is this understanding that despite all I've achieved, Ki Ephrani Elokim, even though Hashem has made me extremely fruitful, it's all Be'eretz Onyi, in the land of my affliction. You know, Chanukah is such a great Yom Tov because it reminds us of the Chanukas Habayis. It reminds us of the rededication of the Beis Hamikdash. And even though here where we are in the United States of America and we think to ourselves, Ki Hifrani Elokim, Hashem has made us fruitful, we are extremely wealthy. You know, the halacha brings down that when it comes to a menorah to light, a Chanukiah, the Chanukah menorah, to light on Chanukah, it's preferable, if one can afford it, to have one of metal, precious metal, silver. I walk on 13th Avenue in our neighborhood at times, and I see the myriad number of silver stores displaying the tremendous wealth, Baruch Hashem, that the Jewish people possess. Menorahs of small and large height, weight, beauty, ornamentation, out of silver, most luxurious. And Baruch Hashem, we have all this fruitfulness and all this wealth. But I think it's important to keep in mind that the wealth that we have and the fruitfulness that we have is all for Chanukah, which is for the dedication of the Beis HaMikdash. We shouldn't forget, Ki Hifrani Elokim Be'eretz Onyi. Hashem has made me fruitful in the land of my affliction. This is not home. This is Ki Hifrani Elokim Be'eretz Onyi. Yosef, at the top of his game, at the top of the world, recognized it's be'eretz on ye. We too, we have to keep in mind that when we're lighting the menorah, we're desiring the rekindling of the menorah in the Beis HaMikdash itself. As we say in the Al Nisim, v'edliku neros b'chatzros kodshecha, and they lit candles in the courtyards of your holy house. The truth of the matter is, only in the Beis HaMikdash was the menorah lit, but it lit up the courtyards of Yerushalayim through its holiness. And that's what we strive, hope, pray, and long for. And every time we light the Hanukkah menorah, we keep in mind the Nisim that Hashem did by Yom HaMaheim, Bazman HaZeh, and that He once again should do those miracles for us. And even though we're fruitful and we're blessed, Ki Yifrani Elokim be'eretz anyi. You know, even in Eretz Yisrael, it's true, that's our home. But until the Beis HaMikdash is built, it's still be'eretz anyi. We may say, Nes Gadol HaYosham here in Chutz La'aretz, and they may say, Nes Gadol HaYopo in Eretz Yisrael. But we shouldn't lose sight of the grand prize. V'edliku neros v'chatzros kodshecha. We should once again light the menorah in the courtyards of the holy Beis HaMikdash. And we should be like Yosef, who always remembered his roots and his home, because even though he was fruitful, it was be'eretz anyi. We should be zoche through the miracle of the Jewish people's survival and the continual lighting of the candles of the menorah, that we should be brought back home. We should go back home. And we should have the zechus, the merit, of seeing the lights kindled. B'chatzros kodshecha. Have a wonderful Shabbos Chanukah. A wonderful Chodesh Tov. A wonderful Yom Tov. And enjoy the light, the spirit, no matter where we are, to see once again the lights kindled. B'chatzros kodshecha. Have a wonderful Shabbos.